Come on, Mick, time's a ticket.
One afternoon we came home from school and it was raining buckets. We decided to walk up to our local park at Five Rock Park, and we discovered this huge dirt hole in the ground. We're like, you know, what's going on here? Why is this hole being dug here? And so we got in there being kids and mucking around, playing in it, not really realizing what it was going to become. And so my friend actually managed to run out of this bowl of mud, and I couldn't do it. And from that very day, I was like, someday I'm gonna run out of this mud hole. It was like 3 meters deep, and you know, 9, 10-year-old kids. And that summer, the skate park was finished, and I went up there on my old 70s style scooter and saw this huge concrete playground, and there was skateboarders everywhere on it. And I was like, so that's what it's for. And I ran home, ditched the scooter, grabbed the skateboard, and from that day, I just copied everyone that was there, all the skaters that were around 17 or 18 at the time who could already do really good tricks. And they just took me under their wing. So from the very start, I had that influence and guidance from my peers. The community among skate parks, not only here in Australia, but around the world, I mean, I've done a fair bit of travel internationally, and it seems like it doesn't matter if there's a communication barrier of any sort. You can travel to pretty much any part of the planet to a skate park, and there's always going to be that core group of local riders, whether they be kids or pro skateboarders or amateurs or whatever, anywhere from quite young to very old, you know. And I've been to Germany and met some guy at the skate park, and with hand signals ended up having a place to stay. So on an international basis, that's great, but on a local basis, you just get these really tight groups of kids and parents and pro skateboarders that localize a park. And if a pro from out of town turns up, or even a kid or an amateur, they'll feel pretty much welcome straight away. Sometimes there's some standoffish attitude towards it, but most of the time, if you can turn up and prove yourself as a skateboarder, that you're there to have fun and enjoy yourself, people are pretty accepting. And the friendships you create at a skate park are far beyond any friendship that I've made at school or out at a bar or anything like that. You know, the fact that if skateboarding is your passion, you'll spend a lot of time at a skate park, and that means you're always going to be exposed to these people that are localizing. So you create pretty strong bonds and some pretty amazing friendships come out of it. Back in the early 80s, when I started skating full on, the community in Sydney was very small, even Australia-wide, and it was pretty much a case of every skateboarder in Sydney knew everyone else. There was maybe 20 or 30 of us at the time, or maybe 50 at the most, and we all used to travel to each other's skate parks, so we all knew each other. But then when the mid-80s came along, videos came out. The first skateboarding video came out by Pal Peralta, called the Bones Brigade Video Show. That changed everything. You know, kids were seeing skateboarding on TV for the first time and really getting into it. And there was just a population explosion. So we went pretty much from maybe a couple of hundred skateboarders to thousands overnight. So it went from a really tight, close-knit community to just small pockets everywhere. So it was really, you know, for the first time you'd see a skateboarder in the street and you go, oh, who's that guy? I've never seen him before. And that's when we finally realized how big skateboarding actually was. And it just keeps, every 5 years, it just compounds itself again and again and again. So just the Sydney skateboarding community alone is, you know, 100 times bigger than it was 30 years ago when I started. When you're at a skate park, discipline is is something that you don't realize that you actually attain that over time. I mean, there's park etiquette involved. You know, when a stranger turns up to a park and doesn't realize how people ride the facility and you know, what people do for their runs and stuff like that, there can be initial conflict, but once you stick around for a while and see how people are skating, you'll understand the etiquette behind it. But discipline wise, you know, I've seen a lot of reserve kids, including myself when I was growing up, just come out of your shell. And you know, so you learn a few, I've been a skateboard coach for since I was 16 years old, so that's like 24 years now. And there's always patience and perseverance. You know, if you spend the time with skateboarding, you'll learn the tricks that you'd like to learn. And perseverance, just, you know, you have to keep trying and trying and trying over and over again until you make it. So there are two qualities that you can take it back out into life. You know, and if you can be, have empathy for other people around you and understand that what troubles they might go through in life and help them at a skate park, and that patience and perseverance can help you with those friendships as well. What got me into skateboarding when I was really young, I think was the freedom. You know, I was a pretty reserved child and had a strict upbringing with my father, so I was always told to, you know, sit down, be quiet, and listen to what was going on amongst the adults. So I was never really that open sort of child who would get into team sports and stuff like that. So that singularity of skateboarding and having the freedom and creativity to do what I wanted when I wanted was what attracted me the most. So yeah, and it's stayed with me to this very day. I still love it for that reason. When I grew up, I was taught to skate by my peers. There was no skateboard videos or YouTube or anything like that for people to, you know, just plug in and turn on and watch and learn from. So I come from an era where the only way to learn a new trick and how to skate was from watching other people and them giving you advice. So even from a very young age, I garnered my first sponsorship when I was 13 years old and started entering contests the very next day. Well, I was already entering contests at the age of 10 actually, but that was my first foray into professional skateboarding. And through that time, just meeting other kids and localising skate parks out at Manly Beach and here at Bondi and out at Five Dock, I just found that kids would always come up to me and say, "Hey man, can you help me? How do you do this trick?" And I'd be more than happy to help them because that's how I learn. And so if I can pass on that knowledge, I'm more than happy to. And becoming a skateboard coach was just that next step. You know, being paid for it's great, but the satisfaction I get from a young kid walking away with a huge grin on his face, having just learned a trick that he's always wanted to learn, the satisfaction I get that from that is fantastic. Skateboarding in its many forms, it's you know, that's the great thing. It can be a solo activity or it can be a group activity. It's always the best times, the best sessions you have skating are always those ones with your closest friends, you know, the guys that you enjoy skateboarding with, and you always sort of egg each other on, and when one person's skating really well and having a good day, that motivates the other guys to step their game up and give it their best. So those fun, friendly sessions when it's maybe five or six of you and your best friends hanging out together, they're the best days. It is an art form, form of stress relief, major amount of fun, keeps me fit. You know, I thought when I was 15 years old, I thought I'd probably kill myself skateboarding by the time I'm 30, but here I am at 40 and still skating and still enjoying it and still progressing. You know, I find I'm still learning tricks. So to me, I found it to be a fountain of youth more than anything. I can be up in the air above the bowl anywhere from, you know, 2 feet to 10 feet and just get that weightless sensation. And, you know, I look down and I can see this big bowl underneath me, and I can see the platform and the people standing behind me, and just get that weightless sensation, and there's nothing like it that I can describe. The inspiration I get from anywhere from a 5-year-old to a 50-year-old who still skates, I'll take that on, and that's what keeps me going. You know, there used to be a skateboarder by the name of Bill Dorr in America, and he used to ride pools like the one here at Bondi at the age of 77 and carve around and do grinds and airs and stuff. So that's a pretty inspirational guy right there. And if I can make it to the age of 77 and still be skating pools, I'll be happy.